Hey, it's Matt and Lizzie in the morning. And did you realize that people can listen to us anytime they want?
They can?
Nonstop if they wanted to.
No.
Yeah, it's Matt and Lizzie on demand. And it starts right now.
Actually, they're getting a lot better now, being able to like represent a lot of different body types. But it is, I remember going in high school with my mom, jean shop. Oh my God, girls, do you remember this? When our moms used to take us pants shopping, bra shopping, whatever shopping. Oh, don't even get me started on bathing suits. And I would cry in the dressing room because
really?
It just didn't. Yes. Oh my gosh, yes. I was so defeated because I couldn't ever find what my body needed. I always had to try to make my body fit in to what they were making. And now, thankfully, there's a lot of more inclusive, equal brands for all of our body types. But geez, back in the day, I mean, when I was young, it was tough. It was really tough. So yeah, Matt, I can definitely sympathize.
Thank you.
With your inseam situation. I'm glad that there's an easy result for you to go online and just order it. So
yeah,
it's not really a problem.
Well, I mean, it has been though.
So
it has been.
Yeah.
And the real test will be when they get here and I put them on.
I guess so. I can't wait. That's going to be riveting.
In. Yeah. I'm going to bring them in.
Riveting.
I feel like you're mocking me slightly.
I totally am.
92 Moose.
92 Moose, Central Maine's number one hit music station. Good morning, Matt and Lizzie in the morning. Shout out to my two youngest, Gavin and Dawson. Headed to daycare at Pitta Patta Playhouse this morning. Good morning, boys. They should be in the car. If not, well, they're running late. So anyway, 7:08 here at the Mighty Moose. And this morning we're asking you to tell us about a time you tried something new, like for the first time.
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, wow. I'm good at this.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of comments at the Facebook page. Do you have them up?
Yeah, of course.
Oh, okay.
Brittany Blaze has a picture. She sent us a picture. Drawing is something that she didn't realize she was going to be good at. And she sent us a picture and she sketched her hugging a child.
Oh, wow.
And
I'm seeing it now.
And it is absolutely incredible. We also have Mallory Riley saying parallel parking. That's something I didn't think I was going to be good at, but I nailed too, honey.
I think people are much better at things like parallel parking than they give themselves credit for. The problem is you get a preconceived notion that you're going to be off on that you can't do it. And I think a lot of times, like anything else, that inhibits your ability to really
That's
be good at
something. That's manifestation, honey. If you don't think you can do something, you're not going to be able to do it.
I make fun of manifestation. Okay? I can't be out
that
here promoting
it. That's exactly
it.
What it is. That's Stop. The true definition of
oh,
it. So if you
nuts.
Feel at first like you can't do something, change the way that you're thinking. Say you can and it'll be easier. Brian Finmore says falling down.
Yeah. I'm right there with you, buddy. Right there with you.
He's really good at falling down.
And the other thing, too, is it's like Britney's, for example, she posts that unbelievable drawing that she did. And sometimes, like, don't you just get angry with people who are just naturally so good at something without any sort of practice
this
or tenure
is,
in the
This
in the
is
art.
When I get angry. Not so much because I love supporting. I'm just grossly supportive of people, especially women. The times when I get angry if somebody is good at something is when they don't shut up about it.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay?
Right. Yeah.
So
totally,
when they're good at it and they're not really on a soapbox, they just won't let it go.
Yeah,
they just keep going
right.
and going. Hey, did I tell you this? Remember? And you're like, oh my God.
Yeah.
Okay.
Totally
you can
hear
yarn.
That.
High five. Let's
can,
move on with our
can,
life.
What is yarning?
Doing the yarns. You know?
You mean knitting?
It's like, no.
You mean knitting?
No, it's yarning.
I don't think it
it's
is.
It's yarning, 92
Moose.
Here's what's trending
on Pop Crush Nights.
Hey, it's Donnie. Join me and Lauren tonight, starting at 7 for Pop Crush Nights. It's all about powerful women, and we have a very special Tate McRae announcement. We're going to let you know, fill you in, and Love is Blind. I'm obsessed with it, but some of the women on there be acting a fool. Can't wait to get into it. Party starts at 7. We'll see you there.
92 Moose.
Yeah, we'd like to say good morning to Peyton, Lizzie, Izzy, and Indiana. Not to be confused with our own Lizzie.
Wait.
Different Lizzie.
I didn't tell you because now I'm a part of Stage Presence.
Oh, you are? That's
great. Yeah, I just did a kick you didn't see, but it was incredible, and I have a good point and a good arch. I'll show you after the show, okay?
Oh, my word. Here we go. Stage Presence for Dancers, big fundraising opportunity coming up in March.
with an auction. So who wants to step up and tell us all about this event and how people can participate in this?
Yeah, Lizzie's going to go first because best name ever.
We are hosting a Mardi Gras mixer, our 12th annual dinner dance auction. And it is on Saturday, March 9th at the Winslow VFW. This event is a 21 and over event.
21 plus. That means there's going to be a couple of beers.
That's
there.
Right, baby.
Now, as far as tickets in advance, is that something people need to do? Buy tickets in advance or at the door?
Okay, you can get tickets via the link we have posted on our Facebook page. And there are two ticket options, one with dinner and one with a later entry fee after dinner.
Perfect. And again, do you guys have a preview of any of the auction items that are going to be up for grabs?
Yes, there will be 50-50 drawings, raffles, games, and hundreds of items to win during the raffle or the live auction. Some of the items include Sugarloaf tickets, a fire pit, youth sports camps, park passes, guiding fishing trips, and many gift certificates to local businesses.
So there is all kinds of stuff up for grabs at this. And again, all going to benefit stage presence for dancers. Now, speaking of dancers, you said this was an auction, a dinner, and a dance. So give us a little info on what's for dinner and the entertainment for the dancing afterwards.
Dinner catered by the Parsonage House. Lori Dumont has created a fabulous Southern dinner for us. We will have DJ Mel B and play steady for a fun party.
Peyton, you're the only one that hasn't spoken yet. We got to get you on the radio. At this point, now I think we got all the info. You can say whatever you want.
Yeah.
Actually, how about you give us a little background on stage presence for dancers? Maybe what you do there, how long you've been dancing.
I've been on the dance team for 3 years, and I love to travel around the world.
That's awesome.
That's beautiful.
So much fun. Do you guys have any travel opportunities coming up? Are you?
Yeah.
Is this a fundraiser for a specific trip or just for the dance team in general?
Yeah, this event benefits our whole team and our travel opportunities to compete across the country. Some of us will be headed to Myrtle Beach summer, New Orleans, Bethesda. The whole team is going to Bethesda, Maryland coming up. So this helps to offset some of the costs that we accrue as families.
So you guys go everywhere.
We really do. It's been really fun.
Suddenly I'm interested in becoming a dancer.
You should. You should.
I
got to do it, but I got to shout out Elma Lee's Dance Studio because that was the studio
I danced at
for like 6 or 7 years when I was younger. I did tap and ballet and point, and I lost 2 toenails doing point.
Oh, God.
Because I would cut them like right before I watch this, guys. Okay, wait, hold on.
Oh, my
flap,
word.
Heel, heel, brush, heel, toe, heel. Oh, and the time step. And time steps.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. And, and jazz and acro and all the things. Dance is a sport.
Oh, 100%. My sister was a dancer for many years.
It's incredible.
Yeah. I didn't get to do anything as a child because we were always at dance.
Yeah. Of course.
That's where it was.
Of course. Remind them when and where this is again, Matt.
Don't miss the auction, dinner, and dance March 9th, Winslow VFW with stage presence for dancers. A great cause, and it's going to be a great night out. 21 plus, so get a sitter and come home with some really cool items and probably a couple of stories to tell. Again, March 9th, Winslow VFW. Click the ticket link at their event page, or you can grab that at the 92 Moose app or at 92moose.fm.
Now, Matt, you have to do a PK turn for all of us.
I don't know what that
come
is.
Come on, do it.
I don't know what
PK.
It is.
1, 2, go. Yes.
I don't know what that
so
is.
Good.
Peyton, Lizzie, Izzy, and Indiana, thank you girls so much for coming in this morning.
Fish.
92 Moose, Central Maine's number one hit music station, Selfish, a trending track from J to the T. It's Matt and Lizzie on the Moose. Coming up, they have grown a human body part in a lab.
Oh, my gosh. We're going to talk about this. I'm so excited.
For the first time ever. We'll get to that coming up just after 8 o'clock this morning. Right now, it is time for the 92 Moose Tweets of the Day. Take a look and see what's trending on X this morning, shan't we? This is from Krista Payson. Why are people so determined to break the ice when the ice is just fine the way it is? Thank you very much. This is from I Hide From My Kids. Sign my petition banning extroverted baristas from working the morning shift.
Yeah.
Don't talk to me.
Good morning.
Don't talk to me. This is from Mo Moeller. That little pocket on the side of your jeans.
Yeah.
It's to carry extra ramen flavor packets at all times.
Oh my God. Look at this. It would fit perfectly.
This is from Megan. My 6-year-old got home from school and crawled into bed with a tube of Pringles, so I guess it was a rough day in kindergarten.
Oh, honey.
Let's see. I'll give you a couple more. This is from the Sassiest Semite. It's not really Wednesday. It's just 3 stupid little Mondays in a trench coat.
Yeah.
And 2 more. This is from Trash Jones. Maybe hell is just a bunch of people singing you happy birthday in a crowded restaurant for eternity. All right. This is your bonus tweet today because this is the same from True Toronto Girl. Ordered blackout curtains today for my bedroom so that I can have insomnia in the dark at any time.
That's beautiful.
There you have it. It is the Naughty Tumas tweets of the day. Follow us at Naughty Tumas.
Good morning.
That is Bruno Mars and Marry You. It's Matt and Lizzie in the morning.
And it's 222, babies.
My favorite event of the year.
Which one?
Is headed to Augusta. I'll give you all the details coming up.
Yay.
In about 15 minutes. Ooh. What a tease. First, though, I did want to mention this because I read a lot of news, as you know, because I'm always yelling at my phone. Most of it's political that I read, but I just happened to end up on an article last night from a medical journal, and they were talking about some new breakthrough science. Now, using stem cells, scientists have been able to recreate certain human elements and even certain human body parts. Now, over the years, using lab-grown stuff. I mean, I'm not Bill Nye. I don't know. But they have been able to grow brains, hearts, lungs, stomachs, and colons.
So incredible, guys.
Which, of course, they use to help fight disease or, you know, again, I don't claim to know much about this. I just read it and go, wow, that's above my pay grade.
What are they working on right now?
Well, they were working on it, and now they've successfully done it. And this is to help combat infertility in men.
Okay.
The first ever lab-produced testicles.
Okay.
Lab-produced testicles.
I mean, if
testicles.
They're doing stomachs and brains and eyeballs, I mean, why not do every body part?
They say that the breakthrough provides a promising model for research that may advance our understanding of the organ's development and translate into therapeutic applications for male infertility.
That's awesome.
Which is absolutely amazing.
Yeah, it's incredible.
Test tube testicles.
Test tube testes.
Man.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, this brings a whole new meaning to the term grow a pair.
Maybe.
92 Moose.